We are learning more about the NASA astronaut crew who is gearing up for the next mission to the International Space Station. Megan McArthur is a UC San Diego graduate who will pilot the SpaceX Dragon when it's expected to launch next month. I had a chance to talk to her today about this upcoming six-month-long mission, exactly what it means to be the pilot, and the unique way she'll stay in contact with her husband and six-year-old son. As a pilot of the SpaceX Dragon, Megan, what exactly are your responsibilities?
So I help monitor the spacecraft systems basically through all the different phases of flight, and I work closely with the commander of the Crew Dragon, Shane Kimbrough, sit right next to him. And as we've gone through all of our training, our simulations, if anything, if the vehicle sends us an alarm about anything, I provide him that systems information while he continues monitoring where the vehicle is and where it's going.
Talk about the toughest part of training and preparing for a mission like this.
So it's being able to jump from one thing to the next and bring your complete focus to every one of those things that can be a challenge.
You spent some time in San Diego at UCSD. How did that time that you spent here prepare you for what you're about to embark on?
I loved my time in San Diego, and I still miss it. At the Scripps Institution of Oceanography, I studied underwater acoustics. And so one of the things that we did was deploy and recover instruments in the water, so scuba diving, and then also from ships. And so I have had some time working shipboard and working underwater, and all of that, I think, helps prepare me to work in space because, you know, when you're out at sea, you're on a ship. If your equipment breaks, you need to be able to fix it. You need to know how to operate that equipment. You might have someone you can call on the radio, but really you need to be able to do a lot of tasks yourself.
I'm guessing claustrophobia is not something that you deal with.
No, that hasn't been a problem, fortunately.
I know when you fly up there, you're going to be bringing a tremendous amount of cargo along with you, but what personal items are you going to be bringing?
I do have some personal items to bring. I'll have some trinkets for all of my family to bring home to them. And then one thing that's important to me is to stay connected with my son. We love to read, and so I'll be able to read stories to him while I'm up there, which is something that we do here at home as well. So I'm looking forward to that.
Can you walk me through how that's going to work? Is it as simple as like a FaceTime conversation?
We have a great team of folks here on the ground that provide us. It's called the Behavioral Health Group, and they provide us lots of different stuff. One of the things they do is provide your family with a tablet that you can basically do a video chat directly to the International Space Station. And so that's a tremendous capability that we have that really helps. It really helps you just stay connected with home.
A six-month-long mission is a long time. What do you hope to accomplish by the time you start and finish?
You know, it's important to not pick any one thing that, oh, I want to achieve this one thing or do this one activity. I think it's really approaching every day with the idea that we're going to be successful for all of the things that we have on the schedule today. And then maintaining, you know, maintaining a pace throughout that doesn't burn you out and that helps you stay successful that whole time.
So again, they are set to launch coming up on April 20th, if not a few days after that. But she sounds more than ready. She's actually been to space before. The first time was a 13-day mission. This will be 6 months.
Sounds like she's ready, though.
Oh, my goodness. The training, the preparation, the education that goes into this, it's almost a lifetime of preparation before you're actually sitting on that space shuttle ready to head up.
I can't imagine the focus and the mental toughness needed to deal with all of that. And yeah. Good for her.
I wouldn't be in the running.
Yeah, wish
not
I
mean, for a moment.
Me either. Not even close.